Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Linda Ueppeibun from Research Institute for Health Science, Chiang Mai University. Today, I will present the results from our study named Amnestic Neurocognitive Impairment in Older Adults Living with HIV with Immune Recovery Following Delay Antiretroviral Treatment in Northern Thailand. This study is a part of the HIV Elderly Cohort Study in Chiang Mai, Thailand. We have no conflict of interest to declare. In the era of effective antiretroviral treatments, profound HIV-associated neurocognitive disorders were rarely seen. However, inferior neurocognitive performance among people living with HIV were documented in studies from different parts of the world. Currently in Thailand, there were older adults living with HIV who were initiated on ART under the National Scale-Up of HIV Care Programs in the year 2000. Many has been living with HIV for years before ART become available and accessible. During that period, only individuals with evidence of immunosuppression demonstrated by low CD4 count were eligible for the treatment. Delay ART initiation has allowed more time for the virus to enter the central nervous system and cause chronic inflammation. In this study, we determine the neurocognitive performance in older adults living with HIV and possible associated factors. This cross-sectional study was conducted in 12 community hospitals in Chiang Mai, Thailand, between September to November 2020. The study population were older adults living with HIV aged 50 years or older in the elderly cohort, which aim to follow the quality of life and health outcomes of older adults living with HIV, starting in 2015. All participants who present in 2020 were invited to join this study. Demographic and clinical data were extracted from hospital records. Cognitive performance was assessed by trained investigator using the Thai version of Montreal Cognitive Assessment, or Thai MoCA. It has been validated with acceptable internal consistency for screening of amnestic mild cognitive impairment and Alzheimer's disease at the cutoff score of 25 and 18, respectively. The demographic characteristics of study participants are shown in the table. 59% were female. Their median age was 61.8 years. 87% were diagnosed as having HIV infection during 1998 to 2013, with the median time from diagnosis to the treatment initiation of 15 years. Their median duration on ART was 10.5 years. At the time of this study, their mean CD4 count was 484, and 99% of them were virologic suppressed. 44% had comorbidity including renal disease, diabetes, and dyslipidemia. Of the 268 participants who completed the test, the median MoCA score was 20. As you can see in the figure, the highest domain score was seen in orientation, followed by naming, and the lowest domain scores were in language and abstraction. There were 54% who met the screening cutoff for amnestic mild cognitive impairment, and 38% met the screening cutoff for Alzheimer's disease. The multivariable linear regression analysis revealed that age, years of formal education, and duration on ART were independent factors associated with MoCA scores. When compared to other studies in patients with HIV using MoCA in the US, Malaysia, and Bangkok, Thailand, with similar CD4 count and virologic expression rate, our cohort were at older age, living with HIV for longer, and received less formal education. All factors might also explain low MoCA score in this study. In conclusion, from our study results, we document impaired neurocognitive performance in older adults living with HIV with immune recovery and virologic suppression following delayed ART initiation. More than half of older adults living with HIV in this study had at least amnestic mild cognitive impairment. Further assessment of functioning is required in those with low scores to learn whether they have cognitive symptoms or problems in daily living. Now that early ART initiation is mandatory, screening program to assess neurocognitive function in older adults and more research to identify potentially modifiable factors related to neurocognitive performance might be beneficial. Thank you for your attention.